Hi everyone. Local time is now 7:44 a.m. So I'm going to say good morning and welcome back to my channel. I'm Maddie and I don't have a niche, I have opinions. If you're new to this channel, I like to make content based on writing, PC gaming, as well as have open conversations surrounding those things. Today I am doing yet another writing stream dedicated to Unfriendly Black Mutants. Oh, and happy Preptober Day 10. So for today's writing stream, I'm going to be focused on another main character named Lauryn Williams. She is one of four main characters. Now, what I know about her so far, and she, in my opinion, of the four, had one of the most compelling storylines to me. So she's a telekinetic. And she also had an accident to where she de-aged back to a toddler and had to relive her life all over again. So because of that, it has bred some anger in her life. And then it bred some resentment when she started remembering some things in her former life, which I'm hoping to, over time, bring some of that out. Now, because I have a busy day today, I'm only going to do an hour. And I'm gonna pop in and out the chat as best as you know I can with ADHD and my lightning focus and all. So with her, I actually started her character sheet. It's just I've handwritten it, and here's some of the handwritten notes that you can see. And I'm actually have to go back to do just a little bit more research on some of her powers to make sure I get them fit into the storyline and everything. Yeah, but for the most part for this stream, my goal is just to like work on her character sheet. And I may need to do some extra work outside of that too. So this may be part one of another stream. Okay, so without further ado, let's get started on building Lauryn Williams. Good morning, Dicer. And yes, I'm working on Unfriendly Black Mutants. Oh, you saw the trailer? Okay, what did you think? You said you loved it. What did you think about it? Okay, so because the comments aren't displayed, one of my viewers, Dicer, was just saying that he can't wait for this to be turned into a screen adaptation. Honestly, I really would love for this to become a screen adaptation. And it really does have the potential. And I know it'll be a long way to go before we can get like a screen adaptation, but at least the novel, like, being written is the first step to a possible screen adaptation. But I would really love for this to become a screen adaptation. That's actually one of the goals. Okay, so I want to address these comments real quick. Okay, so Daisha said, no matter if it's Netflix or Amazon or Hulu or even Disney Plus, the story needs to be told. Okay, so I'm not trying to I'm not trying to knock any streaming services, but if I had my pick, I would say out of those four, I would say either Amazon or Hulu. And the reason I'm saying that, and it's probably not completely Netflix's fault, but I think Netflix, probably in my words, but anyone who knows that Netflix has a slight colorism problem knows what I'm talking about. But I feel like Netflix is one of those things where it's kind of like casting directors keep picking like light-skinned and biracial girls, and as a company, they're like not trying to really do much of anything about it. That's just so, I wouldn't want Netflix to do it because, you know, of the colorism problem, and I'm like very adamant about the main four characters being dark-skinned girls. So that's what it, but I would rather like Amazon or Hulu, and the reason why I would probably not want Disney Plus is literally because Disney Plus and Disney as a whole just have like a big series of controversies. So that's why I wouldn't personally want Disney to like produce this in a film. Like, so that's just all I want to say. But I agree, this story needs to be told. And honestly, this is one of the few projects that I'm really looking forward to. Even as my own project, I'm really just having a fun time rolling with it because this is, to me, one of the few projects where we get, like, these black stories being told. And they're not trauma. And at least it's, like, if it's in a fantasy world. Granted, I'm still dealing with, like, you know, serious issues. Like, you know, racism, privilege, and things like that. But it's not, like, in a trauma sense, is more of like in a it's more of a symbolism, and it's like if you read it, you kind of understand the symbolism, but it's still like with actual people, not like Zootopia or like anything else that tries to explain these topics, but like with non-human people. It's really these are people who look human. They have these distinctive skin colors. You can see the difference in the treatment. You know, things like that. So, that's kind of what is going on. And then it's not like, it's not trauma-based. It's still like a fun fantasy world you can get into. So, that's why I really wanted to do this story. And then, honestly, I felt like I was not the only one who could tell it. I think someone else could tell it just as well as me. But I wanted to tell it. I wanted to be the one to tell it. And I'm just picky. And so I kind of felt like if I let someone else, and I really wanted someone else to do it, but I kind of started feeling like if I don't do it, no one else is going to do it. And then if they do it, I'm not gonna like how it's done. So I'm like, I might as well just do it myself. So, the joys of being a black creator, because that's a lot of black creators tend to do that thing where it's like, since you're not going to do it, I'll do it myself. So, yeah, I just wanted to address that right quick. But, yeah, I'm really looking forward to this project. I'm really excited for this part. I've never really been excited for any writing projects as I have with this one. So yeah, you can see the excitement on my face. I glow when I talk about this project. So, but I'm gonna keep working on it. Okay. So, in reference to questions about what I plan on doing with her, so I actually do have her ending figured out, and it kind of feeds into book two. I'm still saying unofficial because I don't think it's going to happen, but something in me keeps saying it's going to be book two. So I kind of have her ending figured out already. Now, I haven't really thought about whether or not someone's going to fall in love with Celicorne. I know that was a possibility. But it's still a possibility, so I may consider that, but there's still the thing of her age, and I'm still trying to figure out like how and when I'm gonna create a character. Actually just figured out how I can go about a character that would work for her age wise, but I don't think it will be inside of the school, because her ending kind of takes place outside the school because she graduates out. Honestly, just from what I'm gathering, where my thoughts are, it sounds like a lot of things from book two may just take place outside of school, outside of the school for some reason, because I really think something is going on that I can't fit in this one, but I may be able to explore in the next one. Now, Attack Power Mutant. Actually, Carson is the one that gets the Attack Power Mutant boyfriend. So, a little spoiler, but yeah. Now, it's all about whether or not I can build the chemistry and things like that. Okay. I'm gonna read this comment out loud because I heavy agree. So Dicer said, just don't go Romeo and Juliet type. That is so overrated in our reviews. Yes. First of all, Romeo and Juliet, the story is literally just overrated in my opinion. I really don't find it cute. I really just don't. However, I do like the idea of a kind of forbidden love story. Just like in a, in a tasteful way. Because honestly, it's like nowadays, I do kind of like the idea of maybe, you know, her father and another man having a rivalry, and it kind of, I would probably do like one of those rival family love stories. It's just in a tasteful way, because I felt like, the way Romeo and Juliet did it, it was tasteless. And kind of boring to an extent, but I would rather like do that in a kind of tasteful and a more entertaining, interesting way. But I don't know, that's kind of a cool idea to think about, you know, like if the person she kind of gets with is kind of like the descendant of a rival, her father's rival or something like that. That would actually be a good concept in my opinion. Okay, I'm going to read this comment out loud again because, I heavily agree, and this is how Dr. kind of summed up Romeo and Juliet. So, NSFW, for those of you who don't know, that means not safe for work. Both 16, never met anyone outside of their houses. Both horny, and that is not love. That is being too horny for their age. Hard facts. Hard agree. No cap. No print. Just facts. That's it. That's all. Okay, another comment I want to read out loud because I also agree. Okay. You can make them bad girl and good boy. Good girl, bad boy cliche is overdone, overused, overrated. I actually agree, and I'm also... I have in my notes something I wanted to explore with that trope. So it's kind of, a rich boy meets biker girl from the wrong side of the tracks type thing. So that was something I want to explore. Now, it was going to be something I do for Wattpad. So, right now, I'm not going to say whether or not I'm still doing it, but it's in my notes because I literally have several WIPs I'm working on at one time. And so that's one I'm saying is like on the back burner, but I actually may consider exploring that idea. So yeah, I'll think about it. Amy writes, happy Preptober. How's Preptober going for you? Are you working on anything special? Thank you for the follow. Sometimes novel. Hope you enjoy your stay here. Thank you, Sometimes Novel. I'm doing well, and I'm gonna after this, I'm gonna pop in on your page to watch your stream. So, thank you, and once again, writers of supporting writers. Okay, so my timer just went off literally about like 2 minutes ago, but I stayed over just a minute or two because I wanted to finish up something. I didn't get as far as I was kind of hoping to, but I did make progress. So, any small progress is good progress. And that's it for today. Thank you all so much who was live on the stream. Thank you for the ones who are watching the playback. I will link the trailer, the VIP trailer, so I'm feeling back to you down below. Please comment, like, share, however you're feeling. Have a wonderful day. And that is all. Maddie out.